thanks for the very nice introduction, Konstantin. It's good to be back at Think Forward. So I'm here to tell you a little bit about Prometheus, what it is, and how you can use it together with Flink. And as a quick start, I just want to get a feeling for the room. Who here has built something with Flink? Raise your hand. Okay, keep your hand up if you have Flink jobs running in production right now. Okay, still a few. Who here of them has built monitoring around this? And are there people who have done it with Prometheus even? Yeah, handful, okay. So Konstantin has still told you who I am already, so I don't have to do this. So let's jump right in. So this is the logo of Prometheus, if you haven't seen it before. Prometheus is an open source metrics-based monitoring system. So it originated at SoundCloud, originally in 2012. It's now an open source project with a vibrant ecosystem and diverse community, and not controlled by any one company. It's also, you might have heard this, the latest project to graduate from the Cloud Native Computing Foundation. So the first one was Kubernetes, and now the second one, Prometheus, a few weeks ago. And this is a general sign of the maturity, production readiness, and also health of the community. Prometheus is a metrics-based monitoring system. This means it's designed for tracking the overall system health, the overall system behavior and performance, rather than individual events, like, for example, logging systems are made for. It has a powerful data model and query language, which we will see in a few moments, and you can basically use it in any modern language you could want to. Also, it performs really well and it has a wait with the picture. One more. It has a simple deployment model, so it's just a statically linked binary, which also can be run in containers. And this is the GitHub repository you can check out. So in case you don't know anything about Prometheus, here are some concepts I wanted to introduce for the rest of the talks. So I've already talked about metrics. If I'm talking about a metric, I mean, so this is basically a float that changes in time, right? So just a number that changes, and as far as Prometheus is concerned, with millisecond precision. Then I told you or alluded to Prometheus's flexible and powerful data model. This is built on the concept of labels, which are key value pairs that you can associate with metrics. And if you're familiar with more traditional metric systems, you might already guess that this model is more flexible than one where you have a hierarchical data structure, right? Where you have your different information in your metrics names, for example, separated by dots, and this is much more flexible. Then another concept, Prometheus is pull-based. This means you need to tell Prometheus where it can get its data or the metrics, and then Prometheus goes around and fetches this data via HTTP. And this act of fetching data is called a scrape. So you tell Prometheus, okay, there are these metrics endpoints, and then Prometheus scrapes them and fetches all the data. This HTTP endpoint that you need to expose basically in your application has a standardized simple text format, which will now also be even more standardized in a project called Open Metrics. So even more or other monitoring tools will also be using this. And then after having scraped the data, Prometheus stores it internally in a time series database, and the internal engine also is called TSDB. This has been changed a bit with the origination of Prometheus 2.2.0. And should now be even more specialized to the task at hand. So if you have, in a dynamic cloud situations, you might have rather sparse situations. So and now this is even better for this. And then I also alluded to the query language, which is useful, and it's called PromQL. It can be used basically for two things, for graphing, so building dashboards and looking at your data. But usually it's not a best practice to have engineers staring at dashboard and needing to decide whether everything is okay or not. So you can, of course, also have automatic rules which will be able to trigger alerts. An example for a PromQL expression, so it's a really, really simple language, would be here. So we have a metric here, and then we select parts of this metric using a label name and a label value. So we look here at the uptime of all jobs that are called Prometheus example jobs, right? I also told you that Prometheus has a vibrant ecosystem around it, and so there are several integrations. The two most common ones I wanted to tell you about are for dashboards and alerting. So what you're going to use if you're, what you might be using if you want to create dashboards is a tool called Grafana, which you will also see in a few minutes. Grafana has official support for Prometheus as a data source, so this works really well. And then the other aspect is alerting, and there's a separate project which also belongs to the Prometheus family of projects called the Alert Manager. So it's a separate deployable or separate binary. And the way it works is you can define so-called alerting rules. So I have one here, an example. And basically, you give it a PromQL expression. So in this case, I want to be notified in case I have fewer than my expected 2 Flink jobs running. And to be sure that it's not just some temporary issue, I can also tell Prometheus that it needs to that this condition needs to be fulfilled for a given time frame, right? And then, in case this evaluates to something, then the results of this evaluation are turned into alerts. They are sent to this separate binary or deployable, the alert manager. And the alert manager can then turn your alerts into notifications. So be that email, Slack, PagerDuty, systems like that. The alert manager can also do a lot of other stuff. It can aggregate several alerts into one notification. It can throttle your notifications. It can route different alerts or notifications to different teams. You can silence alerts if you know they will be there in an expected downtime, stuff like that. So I hope I succeeded in giving you a very short glimpse into what Prometheus is all about. But we're here to think forward after all. So Stefan said that one of the big enablers of Flink's success is the interoperability, and Flink also works well together with Prometheus. If you know a little bit about monitoring Flink, you might know that Flink has an inbuilt metric system with support for different tools, commercial ones like Datadog or other ones like Graphite or Prometheus. And to use this, you basically need to configure a reporter for your monitoring system. So in this case, you are going to use the Prometheus reporter, straightforward, right? And to do this, it's really easy. You want to make the Java archive available to your class path. So if you're using the latest Flink version, it's just this command. And then you need to configure it in your Flink conf. So, I need to scroll here. Sorry about that. You need to tell it, okay, this reporter uses this class. And then you can also tell it which port to use. One slight subtlety here, as you have already picked up by now, so in order to expose metrics to Prometheus, you need to open up HTTP ports that Prometheus can scrape. In some environments, that's no problem. In other environments, it might be a problem. So for example, if you're running on Hadoop, you might be in a situation where you have several Flink entities. So for example, Flink entities binding to one network interface, basically. So you might have one task manager co-located with your job manager on one physical node, so on one YARN node manager. And in this case, of course, it doesn't work that both bind to the same port. So what you can do in a case like this is just specify a port range, and then it's first come, first serve. So the first one starting up takes the first port, and all successive parties just take the next free port in this range. But now all your job managers and task managers basically expose these metrics in this simple text format via HTTP. Now you just need to tell Prometheus where to scrape. So this is the third step. There are several options. Oh, sorry. Okay. The slides will be available later on, right? the first option for this is the straightforward one. So in static deployment scenarios, you can just configure Prometheus and tell it, okay, there's a class of workloads I call job manager, and they are available under this address. In more dynamic environments, this might not be feasible or might not scale well. So Prometheus also supports service discovery for different frameworks, Kubernetes, Amazon EC2, Consul, and many more. And now all is fine and dandy. The Flink metrics system has a lot of metrics already available to you. So those are the inbuilt metrics. For example, how many bytes or records are going into a given operator or coming out of it, information about watermarks, checkpoint sizes, checkpoint duration, or also most of the connectors like Kinesis or Kafka have exposed metrics or export metrics that are relevant to them. So like the offsets, for example, in this case. But it becomes really powerful if you also integrate your own business logic. So you can use custom metrics in your jobs, right? So I have a very small and hopefully understandable toy example here. So this is just a map that does nothing but count how many events are going through it. And to do this, I just need to use this object, just a counter. I want to register it with my Flink runtime, and then I can increment it on each invocation of this map function. I think you can figure out that this is just a very simple example, and of course, more involved stuff is possible. So now I have shown you a lot in theory. Now I'm going to show you something. And bonus points that I got the right animal, right? So, okay. So, yes. So what I have here now, okay. Mm-hmm. What I hope I have here now is the following. This is now just a local setup on my MacBook here. I have a job manager. Sorry, can people read this in the back? It's better like this, probably. Yeah. Okay. So I have a Prometheus reporter configured here. As you can see in the setup, there seem to be two task managers running. So they're running in a Docker Compose setup. And I have two jobs. One of them is just one of the example streaming jobs, which are contained with Flink. Bear with me. And the second one. I've built for this occasion, so it's also a very simple job. The first operator just generates random numbers up to 10,000. Then I have a map here, which is somewhat like the one you just saw on the slides. So it exposes two metrics, one just counting the events, and then one with a histogram that gets access to all the values going through it. And finally, I'm using a discarding sink, so if you don't know it, it's a useful inbuilt tool if you want to build useless things. Yes, exactly. And if you hadn't known it before, you might know it since the keynote from Stefan, because he showed the task metrics tab here. So this is already inbuilt in the Flink UI with the metric system. So we can get access here to the inbuilt metrics like I told you before. So for example, how many bytes are going out of the source function, and then after some time I get information here. And now I want to show you the metrics that I added to my job. So one is here and called events. It's just a counter going up with time, hopefully. And then the second one is a histogram. So if I open, oh, now it's going up, great. If I open up, for example, the 75th percentile, as I told you, I'm pumping in numbers up to 10,000. So yeah, this value histograms 75th percentile is something like 7,500. Right. So everything up to now is only Flink and Flink's metric system. So now I only have a local Prometheus instance running here. I hope it's large enough. First of all, because there's some timing issue, I want to start with this. So I have the same alert that we saw on the slides earlier. So I'm going to trigger this by going to trigger this by canceling this other job, and then we can look whether our alerting works later on. Okay, so this is canceled. And while this is happening, we can look here at the configuration. So I have here a bunch of other stuff, but so this is an overview site where Prometheus shows me what it knows about the world and which targets it knows that it has to go to and scrape metrics from. And so here we see, okay, one of one expected job manager is up, and also I have my two task managers here, and they are up. I'm scraping them every second. So if I refresh here, you see it also this last scrape time frame refreshes all the time. And then one nifty thing we can use here, which is useful for ad hoc analysis, is the inbuilt expression browser, which also has a good fuzzy finding capability. So my events counting metric I built is right here. And I can just look at the development over time. But I can also now here use all the powerful capabilities of PromQL. So one of the not so powerful ones is I can look at the rate of events averaged over the last minute. So how many events were there? And it seems there was some kind of warm up, and then it's roughly 660 events per second going through this. But now this is somewhat temporary here, this expression browser. As I said, for ad hoc analysis, it's useful. If you want to have something more persistent, you are probably going to use Grafana. Oh, it's very secure here. Sorry about that. Grafana is, Flink was the password if you're wondering. Grafana is a tool with which you can build dashboards. So here I've just duplicated basically the same dashboards we already saw inside of our Flink UI. Here the events counter, which is rising, and then here the histogram with all the percentiles. But this data is now also fetched from Prometheus and Prometheus internal time series database. I've also access, just to demonstrate, to the inbuilt Flink metrics here, so I can see how many bytes are going into given operators or out of. I can see the uptime of a Flink job, and I've also access to more base level metrics, like for example, how is my my memory doing for the task managers, or what about garbage collection. So by now we can just briefly go back to the alert. It should now it's firing. So it has understood basically that now this evaluates to something, and by now I could have gotten SMS or text message or Slack message or whatever. Yeah, so going back to the slides. Nope. This was not on purpose, sorry. Okay. Yes, so if I succeeded in making you curious about what Prometheus is all about and whether it's useful for you to use with Flink, I would recommend you the following. Check out the relevant parts of the Flink documentation and read into the Prometheus documentation. It's really extensive and well written. Also, one of the Prometheus guys, Brian Brazel, has recently published a book called Prometheus Up and Running, which I would recommend. And then two other aspects, which I'm just going to mention. This pull-based model lends itself very well for online systems, web services, streaming jobs, but it's not so good for things with a more ephemeral nature, like batch jobs. And for this particular use case, there is also another project called the Prometheus Push Gateway, which you can also integrate with Apache Flink, by the way. And then another thing, Prometheus, as I said, prioritizes simplicity. So some things are just not in Prometheus core because they want to do one thing and do it well. And one of these things is long-term storage. But by now, there is integration with remote storage, for example, InfluxDB or Elasticsearch. And also, there's recently a really exciting project which tries to establish highly available Prometheus setups, including also long-term storage, which is called Thanos. So if you're interested in this, you can definitely check it out. All the code and the dashboards and so on is all contained in this GitHub repository. You can also use a fancy QR code, of course. I think I'm running a bit low on time, so probably if there are questions, please just contact me on any of these channels or we can chat afterwards. So enjoy the rest of the conference.